you? You look great.
Thank you very much. This is for the European title, Fighting Against the Egg, Jan Wild flyweight title. It's my biggest fight yet today, so it is quite pressurising.
In the pressure, Cathy.
You know, it'd be nice to get a bit of fame and fortune out of boxing. It would be nice to have my name, my household name. You know, the bitch or Cathy Brown. You know, like Lennox Lewis. Like, you know, people know who they are. It would be nice to get recognition for my skill. You know. My skill and my determination to get somewhere. I'm one of these people who have to be the best at everything, and I'm a perfectionist. That's one of my problems, I suppose. That's what it's all about. Money. Money, fame, fortune. Most definitely. There's no real deep meaning or anything behind it. Money. What's my show name? My show name is The Bitch, you know? And personally, I don't see what's wrong with it. The Bitch is a hard name, it's a harsh name. I mean, Cathy Brown, The Bitch. It stands out more, you know? You've got to have that. Boxing's all about entertainment. I mean, it's all about publicity. It's all about media, yeah? It's all about making an impact on someone, you know? If I want to be called The Bitch, then, you know, I don't think anyone else should have a problem with it, because it's me that's calling myself it, you know? I'm giving people allowances to call me it, you know? And that's about the only thing they can call me, though, because if they call me anything else, they get a punch in the mouth. Basically, this is the bitch's workplace. We have to come and make some money at some point because we don't get paid that much with boxing. Basically, what I'm doing today is I'm event managing for the show.
A male audience prefer to come and see Cathy the Bitch Brown than Cathy Brown. That's the bottom line. That equals tickets. So that's one good selling point. Whether or not she's a bitch or not, it's totally immaterial.
Not really. I'm a nice person. Honest.
What rubbish was I just hearing? You're a nice person?
Yeah.
Cathy the Bitch Brown? Yes. You've about 5 minutes. Guess what? The gym has been closed. No, and everyone has left. There's no one here. Everyone has left because everyone will be waiting for you and they ask me why you're not here. Well, you shouldn't be driving a car. You're supposed to get a limousine to come and take you around. Get off the phone. Bye-bye. Thank you very much. We don't want to go out there looking for just points. We go out there to beat you up. If you want to go down, you go down. But we are going to beat you up. We're going to hit you. We're going to hurt you. And that's what I train my fighters to do. I train. I let them understand this is the hurt business. And they got to hurt somebody because that's what people pay. When people go to the Grand Prix, they don't go to watch sophisticated driving. They go to see crashes and things like that. They're not going to admit to that because they're all hypocrites. But that's what they really got to see. That's what entertainment is about. To get your adrenaline going. To get you... get the fear factor. Here comes the bitch. She's always late. It's the last day before we go and do a little bit of peak in fitness. Just get the fighters peak for the situation. It's terrible. It's horrible. But it's what you call putting the dog inside of you. Adversities. That they're competitive. It doesn't matter how they start, one of them wants to win. And that's the thing about boxing. If you want it, you've got to earn it. To a big degree. Putting the dog inside of you makes you horrible. Makes you beastly. Makes you ferocious. So it gives you the will and the spirit.
Use the arms. Good. You've got to relax your body.
We want to please the public. We want to do what professional fighters should do, in my opinion, which is put them on the canvas. Knock out or be knocked out. because we've got about 3 days more in the gym and that's it.
Come on, Miss Brown.
Depends what frame of mind you're in. You can feel like you're going to the gallus, or you can feel you're going to a dance.
Go.
So you've got to get in the right frame of mind to go out there and fulfill our dreams.
You ready? See this lovely, lovely gym.
Out
as the pitch.
Can't go back like this.
The pitch.
Come on, you know what to do. Why are you not holding? Push him back. Don't give him a chance when we get shot back. That's what I'm talking about.
All preparing for the big one. It's fight night. They're all getting nervous. It's fight night. It's coming up.
What I'm talking about, you go back.
Why do people take punches in the head for a living? Why? What, you know, it's the last great question really, isn't it? But you know, for a lot of people, it's a chance, it's the opportunity to get into the big time. It's a world of glamour. Boxing bridges the gap between pure sport and show business. It's somewhere, it's totally unique because it's somewhere in the middle. So as a professional sportsman, you're also a showbiz personality. That's the dream.
Come on, jump.
We're a bit kind of known as off the wall promoters, like promoting women's boxing principally. That, you know, that sets us apart, for better or for worse.
She does want to win. She does want to win. She's got determination. She desperately wants to be a star, and really, you know, that goes a long way.
Men do not like women. You got to ask them that question. You can't ask me that question because I can't speak on their behalf.
Stamp their insecurities.
I think it's just basic chauvinism and ignorance and lack of knowledge. It's lack of knowledge because
there's this insecurity within themselves, to be quite honest with you. You know what I mean? I mean, if they feel threatened by a lady doing boxing, you've got to ask them why. Why do you feel threatened? Why do you think it's wrong? No.
That's right. A woman is just another part of the human race, and she wants to compete in not just boxing, in any sport, in anything. If she's competent and she's capable, then what's the problem?
That's right, that's good, that's right.
But if you talk about punching power, she's got more. She punches a lot more strong than a lot of these guys do. And they don't want to believe that because she punches more correct. She's a real fighter. You know, she is a real fighter because she's a provocative. She's very provocative. She, you know, she's got the will, she's got the desire.
Well, she's fighting a pretty tough girl, Jan Wild, from Stockton, who had a big kickboxing background like Cathy, had a lot of combat experience, and by all accounts, she's a pretty tidy boxer. It's quite a hard fight, but at the end of the day, it's a title fight, so it should be. I'm really not very happy about it. I mean, I don't see how you can get so many things wrong. Right, show.com in association with Transworld Sport and Choice FM bring you War in the South Boxing's Carnival Night on Saturday, July the 1st at the Elephant Cultural Learning Centre. Triple title, Cathy Brown versus Jan Wild, WBF Pan-European Vacant Fly Women's Flyweight title.
Move your head. Move your fucking head, that's right.
That's the spiel and the hype. And boxing really is kind of 200% hype and about 25% reality. And you've got to read into the hype. You've got to be able to see between the lines. And if you can't see between the lines, you know, the hype is just engulfing and swallowing. But hype is a very important issue, isn't it, Gary?
No hype, no fight.
No hype, no fight.
I'm going to drive all the way up to sunny Newcastle to see my mum and dad, and I'm going to see if they'll come to the fight. Try. I don't even realise how important this is, really important for me, this European title, to win the European title. My view on it is that if you, no matter what you do in life, you know, you should kind of support your daughter or your son with whatever you're doing, even if you don't like what they're doing, yeah?
Thank you.
I didn't have any brothers or sisters because I was obviously because I was adopted. I was the only child. My parents didn't adopt any more people, so I was always, as much as everyone wanted to try and make me part of the family, you kind of could tell I felt there was always something missing. I mean, they always, you know, give me everything I ever wanted, so. I chatted him up at the gym, I seen him at the gym, and I thought, he's been all right. I just seen him training downstairs and he had his little vest top on, you know what I mean? And I just thought, ooh. And I knew he always had something to eat after he trained, like up at the cafe at the gym. So I kind of hung around, do you know what I mean? And hung around. And he come up and I kind of just kind of went and sat next to him. And just started chatting to him.
Oh, that's cool. That, this is a fit woman. That was about it, that was my first sort of like, you know, view of her when I first saw her. She's a fit woman and she could fight. Very few women you see is good looking and can fight, you know.
Can you really fancy me?
Yeah.
Did you not?